This is a solar power security camera. They claim it can last 130 days on a single charge and that it only needs 1 hour of sunlight per day to stay alive forever. But if this thing ends up working anything like my solar landscaping lights, it's gonna be an absolute dud. So welcome back to the lab where our opinions cannot be bought. Today we're taking a look at the Eufy Cam S3 Pro kit. We got a kit with two cameras and the home base. The brand Eufy is actually owned by Anker. So if that helps anybody build any kind of trust with the name, I know when I was first hearing Eufy, I was a little skeptical. So we've been using these guys for a couple weeks now here at the lab, and we wanted to share our experience because there was some unexpected things that we actually really liked about these cameras and some things we didn't. If at any point during the video, you just wanna go straight to Eufy and check these things out, we'll leave some links down below as well as any coupon codes that we're able to actually squeeze out of Eufy. Otherwise, we're gonna jump into a super quick teardown to show you guys exactly what it is we're working with if you're not already familiar. So this is the Eufy S3 Pro 2 camera kit. So first up, looking at the home base S380, this is basically like the brains of the system. You can expand the storage inside of this guy up to 16 terabytes. This is also where you have the bionic mind, which basically can identify individual people, cars, and pets, which is kind of cool. We haven't programmed ourselves into the cameras yet, but you can kind of go on the app and you can see like, oh, hey, Robbie showed up today at 909 without actually having to open the footage and watch it to see who showed up. And when some random person comes knocking on our door trying to sell us stuff, it just calls them a stranger. And the home base works with all Eufy's other security products like the doorbells, little screens you can get, more cameras and that kind of stuff. When it comes to the actual cameras, these are 4K cameras. So everything is actually super clear. As you guys can tell, this shot is literally on one of the cameras. It's got a 13,000 amp hour battery. It's a lithium ion battery and it says it only uses 50 to 100 amps a day, so it should be able to last about 130 days on a single charge. It's got a built-in tiny baby 1.07 watt solar panel. You're able to set specific zones inside of these cameras to film only within that specific area, and they're compatible with Apple Home, Alexa, and Google Assistant if you wanted to hook it up through an existing home that you already had with them. They also say that these are extreme weatherproof. Their website shows them frozen in ice, but it's only extreme up to 14 degrees Fahrenheit, which isn't really that extreme. And as far as the camera goes, there's no plugs, cables, or anything. It relies strictly on solar to get power into it. So I love the idea of this thing, but I'm really, really skeptical of the execution. And this kit that we have right here costs $549, which isn't that bad considering there's no monthly subscription. That's like 1 year's worth of monthly subscription costs. First things first with these cameras though, I don't care if it's the coolest camera in the world with facial recognition. We need to make sure that these things actually work because if it dies every 3 days, I want nothing to do with it. So the first test we did was actually checking the battery efficiency on these cameras. And we did this pretty simply. So basically I charged this camera up to 100%, held it hostage, taped over the solar panel, and then I went ahead and installed it on the front porch of our house, which is also under a big overhang. So there's absolutely no way any sun was making its way to this solar panel. And we could basically install it there and just let it run and see how the battery kind of performed without ever getting sunlight in the panel. I took advantage of the fact that I could go ahead and select certain areas where I want the camera to pick stuff up, and I cut the road out of the picture because otherwise this thing will be recording nonstop. We had it set to record in 20-second intervals, so if it detects motion, it records for 20 seconds. I think that's what they call like the optimal battery performance. But we did have it set to like 4K and all the good stuff. And in exactly 3 weeks' time, this thing captured 1,148 events, and the battery only went down to 85%. Which is actually really good. It's also mid to late October, so this thing was putting in work during the night using its night mode and stuff like that. And at that rate, it would still last 138 days on a single charge. I haven't seen something put in work like this and also maintain a battery life this well in a long time. Why I gotta pay so much for a phone and it dies every fucking day? Test two, I wanted to see how well this thing performs when it gets cold. We live in a cold climate. In the winter, you can have a week or two that actually gets
well below 14 degrees.
Very cold. So we went ahead and threw this thing in the deep freezer where we have tested tons of our other products, and 99% of them just self-protect, turn off, and don't do anything. The deep freezer is significantly colder than 14 degrees. We put this camera in there and it was at about 75%. It dropped to 74 almost instantly. I'm gonna say that it was just about to do that anyways. I don't really think the freezer had much to do with it. We left it in there for 24 hours once it cooled down, and it never dropped another percent. It stayed at 74% the whole time. And when I pulled it out, it was still recording. It was still working perfectly fine, which was also pretty impressive. Most of the time when you put a battery in cold weather, the battery just depletes like crazy. It just starts running out of juice super fast. So not bad results. And the last test was charge time. This tiny little baby solar panel, they say this camera, if you get 1 hour of sunlight on it per day, it will last forever. So that basically means if this camera uses about 1% a day, which we know it uses just less than, it should be able to charge about 1% per hour. So we went ahead, threw this thing outside in the sun, left it out there for about 2 hours, checked on it every hour, and it did actually go up about 1% per hour. I then went and grabbed that additional panel we have, which once I had it set up was like the smallest solar panel I think we've ever put in our backyard. It's like a 3-watt little tiny baby solar panel. It's a solar panel for ants. But if you actually look at it compared to this, it's just over double the size of the panel that comes on this thing. So I was hoping it would charge at about double the rate. Went ahead and left that outside for 2 hours. And during 2 hours, it actually charged up 5% into the camera, which is basically exactly what I was hoping it would do. And really, really good. All in all, these things turned out to actually do exactly what they said they would do, which is really impressive and honestly, extremely rare to find in a kind of, what would you call this, like a gadget? The quality of these cameras is probably the thing I like the most. They actually shoot a really crisp, really clear shot. The colors are nice. A lot of times security cameras, when you look at them, you're like, this is a security camera. I really like the additional panel. That's a really cool feature that, especially when you're building a camera that relies just on sun, it's really cool that they allow you to mount it somewhere there is no sun and still get sun to the camera. That's cool. And I really like that it's a bigger panel than the ones on here. So if you are struggling to get sunlight where you live, that's kind of double the input of this. It's just really helpful. I also love how easy this thing is to set up. The app prompts you for every step basically along the way. And then the cameras and the HomePod actually talk to you during the process.
Press the sync button until you hear the beep.
Ready to add device. Device was added successfully.
It's super helpful. You know exactly what to do the whole time. Like this thing is basically idiot proof when it comes to setting it up. And when it comes to installing it, it's actually just super simple. There's two screws that you have to put through the bracket, and then all the adjustments happen on one tightening nut. So basically you can put the camera exactly where you want and then tighten one nut and everything stays where it is. We never had any problem with the camera starting to sag or anything. Just use your big boy fingers, get that tight, and you'll be good to go. I also think it's kind of cool that this has call mode, like a doorbell cam. So if you don't have a doorbell cam and someone is at your door, you can use this to talk to them outside.
What the fuck? Hello?
And I also just really like that there is no monthly subscription with this. It's a completely self-monitoring system, and you can have 16 terabytes of storage. You could basically store, like, depending on how many cameras you have, that's months of storage. I pay probably per year more than this whole kit costs for my security system. Bad deal. There's a small list though of things that I don't like. And the first one, the most obvious one, is that the HomePod that these connect to has to be plugged into the wall. These don't store anything on them, and the HomePod is not solar. So if you have a power outage, your cameras are no longer working. They're working, but they're not saving the footage to the HomePod because the HomePod has no power. So that's a huge flaw to me. That's why the HomePod is not in this shot right now, because for us to shoot with this camera, we need the HomePod plugged in and plugged into the Wi-Fi router so that this camera can store the footage somewhere. So the solution to that would be to get a small portable power station. Basically you can have it plugged into the wall and then the HomePod plugged into it and your Wi-Fi router plugged into it. So if the power ever goes out, they automatically keep themselves turned on. That is an additional cost, and I don't get paid enough to promote a ton of products on this channel. So you guys get what I'm saying. Go check out another video on a small portable power station. Put one there, because if a snowmageddon comes and you have no power and someone breaks into your house, guess who knows? No one, because your cameras were off. I also don't like that 14 degrees is the low temp rating. I get it that it's a battery solar powered thing, I understand. We did go ahead and test it for the 24 hours, it was fine, but that doesn't mean that when snow and ice is built up on this thing and it's outside for a week straight at 0 degrees Fahrenheit that it's still gonna be functioning that well. I just wish that it was like self-heating like some of the batteries that we see or something, just to help keep it a little bit warmer and functioning in a little bit of a colder climate. And the last thing is, unlike Tiny Baby, this thing is quite large. And it's not inconspicuous at all. If you have this on the front of your house, you know what's on the front of your house. You can't hide it. If your neighbor's trying to break into your house, he's definitely gonna know to TP the camera before he does so, because he sees it. At the end of the day, those are just nitpicky things though. They aren't deal breakers. I would say, honestly, the performance and just the quality and everything of these was surprisingly good and completely outweigh all of the cons, but that does not disregard that there are some. Anyways, the verdict, 25 to life, no parole. The verdict on this is, it's Tiny Baby approved. He likes it. I would give it a 9 out of 10. I don't feel bad recommending you to them. Go ahead, check out the links, use some of the coupon codes that we have down below. Otherwise, that is all I got for you guys. I'll catch you guys next time. Thank you so much for watching. Peace out and stay charged.